got rhythm.
It's all coming up.
I've done Bandits. Come on! Oh.
Bandits and another gaming white knuckle ride.
On tonight's show, we're saying Nanu Nanu to Dr. Spock with Star Wars Rogue Leader Rogue Squadron 2 on the GameCube.
We get our hands on some of the most gorgeous games machines on the planet.
We've got the latest news on Final Fantasy X.
And we're taking the piss out of piss artists. Well, they're just artists, actually. But before all that, Iain carves up some white powder and prepares for his après ski with Amped on the Xbox.
Thank God for computer games. Because of them, it means twats like me get to do really cool things without having to hang out with the wankers that usually do them. Snowboarding is a prime example. It looks so exciting and exhilarating, yet every boarder in the world is an arrogant idiot who can only say, "Dude!" That's not an exaggeration, by the way. That's a fact. But Amped on the Xbox is perfect for the indoor sportsman. All the fun of the fair without the fear of the glue-sniffing teenager.
Pull twists in midair, jump over buildings, and do other fun things. It's all here. But the Xbox manages to pull a few tricks of its own, which put the other consoles to shame.
The first being the huge courses. The first couple start out small, but move on from there, and you can go pretty much anywhere.
There is a huge amount of space to cover and explore, and eventually, as you climb the mountain, the tracks begin to link up. And while you're pulling one off behind a tree, check out the amazing view. The backgrounds on Amped are as detailed as you can get. You're also encouraged to impress the media. Photographers, filmmakers, and agents are all out on the slopes watching for fresh young talent. Have a jostle in front of a camera, and you could be signed up to an exclusive sponsorship deal, unlocking tracks in the process. Another trick exclusive to the Xbox is the inclusion of 200 songs on the soundtrack. Pick from six genres, such as punk and Peter Andre, and let the game be your DJ. However, if none of the tunes are to your liking, then do what I did and rip Frank Zappa's One Size Fits All CD to the hard drive and have that blasting out.
My only major problem with this otherwise brilliant game is the lack of a really good racing mode. Sure, four players pretty cool, but I don't know three other people, so I kind of miss racing against the computer.
The lack of other competitors makes the game feel slightly slower than other boarding titles, but this difference is its selling point. It's a stunt sim, not a racer.
If the Xbox can keep releasing titles like Halo and Amped, then I think it won't be long until we're seeing the death of the PS2. That'll learn them.
Back in the old days, pirates only had one eye, one leg, and a pile of parrot poo in their shoulder to worry about.
Yeah, that's right, Aleks. But now, in the 21st century, they've got a whole host of new headaches.
As recent anti-piracy thrust Operation Buccaneer has demonstrated, even the saltiest of high-tech rogues are being caught by the Jolly Rogers.
Due to a number of high-profile raids, many hackers have gone underground. But flying in the face of adversity, British software developers Introversions are releasing the world's first hacker sim, Uplink. Uplink challenges hackers to crack into as many fake computer systems as possible. Hackers are given missions that are posted on the Uplink Corporation's database and range from altering bank accounts to changing social security information.
But if any would-be hackers are thinking of taking their skills to the real world, then be warned.
The FBI are putting the finishing touches to its magic lantern technology that can record your every online keystroke. So games like Uplink may be the last place for hackers to ply their trade.
This week, our review jury of Three Good Men and True are looking at tennis titles. Will they do a Sampras and serve an ace, or will they be more like Henman? Shit.
Our umpires are Scott, the Whispering Games designer, Jackie, the Gobby Games fan, and Paul, who I think may be a ball boy.
Oh, fucking hell.
Let's begin.
First serve goes to Cosmic Smash on the Dreamcast. not so much tennis, more psychedelic Arkanoid mixed with a bit of Breakout. Now, if that sounds as confusing as Greg Rozetsky's claim to be British, don't worry. It's a simple game with striking graphics where you have to smash balls against blocks to escape. Too simplistic? Time to be serious, dude. Is it in or is it out?
Would you say this game was unique, or does it remind you of anything else?
Oh, it reminds me of lots of things. Pong, for starters. Bit of Virtua Tennis in there. And it's a bit like, well, squash and pinball as well.
How does it play?
Well, it's a tried and tested gameplay genre. It's like Pong, like Arkanoid. So it's given the developers the freedom to do what they want with the graphics. Looks really cool. I mean, they've gone for that retro, electro, Tron versus MTV look, which really, really worked.
It's the kind of game for your diehard console fans only, who like to buy every quirky thing that comes out, like Viv Ribbon or Rez, something like that.
Well, I've got Viv Ribbon and Rez. What are you saying? Well,
no, that's okay. The problem with this game is Viv Ribbon, as you know, is based on sort of innovative idea, and it works. Rez, great fun. This is Pong and nothing more. Pong with fancy graphics.
So you're still reeling from the tremendous Henman Sampras upset. Well, I know. I understand. But here's your chance to rewrite history and get over it with Tennis Master Series on the PC.
With full tournament mode, exhibition mode, and a LAN play option, your players sport the latest motion capture technology, and the little court details will make you reach for a Pimm's and Lemonade. But was it convincing enough for our jury?
I didn't think I would like this game, Alex, but it turned out to be really good. The way it looks is enough to draw me in to make me play it for longer. I mean, the way the guys move around the court's fantastic. The motion capture is so good you can read their body language.
I thought I was going to hate it, but after playing for a while, I kind of got into it. I found the controls a bit clumsy, though. Doubles made it a wee bit easier because the computer helps a bit with the running back and forward so you can concentrate on your, you know, your hitting.
It's one for the tennis purists because all the details are there. It's nice. You've got nice sound and the ball bounces, sound of the wind, and it's a real sort of a somber tennis commentators.
15, love.
The final set of this metaphorical tennis match will be played by centre court.
This PS2 title boasts 8 characters, 4 different court surfaces, as well as a mighty array of shots. You can select the length of a game and play in tournaments or single exhibition matches. With up to 4 human players involved in a doubles match, this can be a tense game, unless your partner is my mate Steve, who is rubbish. But does the lack of any real tennis stars make this a poor second to Virtua Tennis?
This comes nowhere near Virtua Tennis. It has set the standard, basically. It had the sort of realism and a subtlety of control, which this doesn't have at all.
And that's from Paul, who works in a game shop, so top advice there. Was this game any good?
Didn't enjoy it that much, Iain. I mean, it was lucky that's something actually you'd expect from a PS2 game. I mean, things like the players suffer from the Scooby-Doo walk effect, with their feet slide around all over the court, which just spoils it for me.
Now, these aren't real tennis players either, are they?
They're not, no, it's a computer game, so...
No, I don't mean real tennis players as they've been captured and put in a tiny box. I mean, people like Henman and all that, the names.
I've got you now. No, they look more like, you know, extras from Mortal Kombat to me. They've got shorts with flames on and big jaws and, you know, hard hair.
It's easy to play, mostly down to the controls. They just seem to be much easier to get the hang of, and the reactions on screen are much faster than the PC game. But I didn't enjoy it as much. I didn't find it as satisfying.
Well, that's tennis, but the results are in, and it appears the umpires are about to strike back. In third place, it's Cosmic Smash, because...
it's quirky, but crap.
Second place goes to Centre Court, because...
it's a bit of a link call, this one.
But this week's winner is Tennis Masters, and I say because...
it's the best of this lot, but it ain't the Masters.
So there you go, tennis. It's not a load of old balls.
Right, Final Fantasy is the Japanese role-playing series that's transported countless computer fanciers into the weird world of electronic obsession.
Possibly the most inaccurate title in history, the series has spawned 8 incarnations in the UK, as well as The Spirits Within, the misjudged but exceptionally animated film. And the good news is, number 10 is coming to the UK soon. The only thing that ties them all together is how they deal with honor, friendship, and saving the world. Number 10, for example, entertains itself with an enlightened dude attempting to save his homeland from something called sin. Very deep, very Japanese. And as far as the UK is concerned, very late.